Here, let's have the first question. Thanks, Mark. Okay, this first question is about hair care. You know, I get so many dear, dear letters about hair care and how I keep my hair so shiny and springy. Well, I want to tell you why. It's because I retain a lot of my own moisture. Let's have a question, Ricardo. That's lovely. Thank you. Now, this question is about how often do I exercise? Well, of course, the answer to that is constantly. I am constantly toning my muscles, but sometimes in places that you won't be able to see under this gorgeous enamel dress. Just little flexings and releasings. In fact, I could probably redecorate this entire set without using my arms. Thank you.
I'm sorry, Joanna. Sorry. Hi. You're actually supposed to come on later as a guest. This is where I do my monologue. Nobody cued me on. I didn't get a cue.
Yes, but everybody was waiting. Everybody's waiting, and I was here, and the crew was so delighted to see me again. And they said, you know, the show never really takes off unless I'm here. Oh, Gordy, I hope I didn't do anything wrong, Ruby.
No, this is where I do my monologue. It's how I start the show. I do monologues.
Oh, I know.
It's a tradition that I do a monologue.
I've seen it on the auto cue. You know, some of it is actually quite funny, you know? I mean, the little quirky way you look at things. And do you know what I love? I love the way you assume that everybody knows what you're talking about. I mean, it must all make some sense in that little head of yours.
I do my monologue about social observation.
Oh, I see. Is that what it is? Okay. Well, look, I'll just be quiet as a mouse, okay? You do your monologue on that spot, and I'll be here, okay?
Hello? Tonight I'm going to talk to you about carpets. It's a topic. Have any of you tried to buy a new carpet recently? You can't just buy one. You have to know the exact depth of pile.
And that's very drowsy. It's the attention to detail that makes us so successful. You know?
Joanna, I just can't go on if you're going to stand behind me being tall.
Just, okay, ignore. I'll be just stock still. No, I tell you what, I practice my model walk, okay?
Anyway, then these guys come over and they measure your carpet. I mean, what kind of a job is that? Joanna, I can't do this while you're behind me.
And actually, Ruby, when you're talking about carpets, I've got this really amusing little story. It's actually not about carpets. It's actually about linoleum in my kitchen. Well, this little Irish man came to see me, and I opened the door to him, and I wish you could have seen his face. He could not believe that he was looking at the Joanna Lumley. And I was just opening the door to him like a regular guy, and I just said, come in. And I took him downstairs, and I had to make him a cup of tea, and I had to sit him down. He was in such a state, and I said, look, darling, we are all part of the human race. Great big stars, little tiny linoleum fitters. Now just get down those stairs and lay that lino. And can I just tell you something? By the time I came back from my hairdressing appointment, that little man had refloored my entire home, and he would not accept a penny for it.
Joanna, could you just finish now? Because I do have a guest, and if you go on, then the whole half an hour will be up.
Yes, but I'll come back if you want me to. If you will want me to come back.
Oh, I love you. I love you. Well, thank you. They do, but yeah. I do have another guest.
Yes,
so
but the guest isn't as big as me. Not as big as me.
Not as big, no. Not as big, but she's, you know, she's made a couple films, and they're little films, and she could just talk about them and then go, and then you could come on.
Yeah, who is she? Who is she?
Tiny person.
Yeah.
Jamie Lee Curtis.
The audience and I were just building up a nice little rapport.
Yes.
We were getting on very well together. They wanted to know about me. They wanted me here to be with them.
But if you could...
Because I want to be here!
Okay. But if you could just go, just for a minute, all right? Okay. All right, I see.
Yes.
So you stay and you talk to them about how
because I'm a success and I didn't
put the moisture from wherever into your cream rinse.
I'm very busy and I
And then I'll just go find Jamie Lee Curtis wherever she is. So, okay? Yeah. So I'll just talk to Jamie Lee Curtis.
God.
Film star.
Jamie Lee Curtis. I mean, what television shows has she done? Let's have another question, shall we? Thank you, Marco. And this one is about personal hygiene. A lot of people do wonder about my personal hygiene. And do you blame them?
Hi, I'm Ruby. I don't need any more. I'm stiff enough. That I do you mind that I interview you in this room? Because on stage,
you know what? I actually don't want to go out.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Well, because I have an egomaniac on my stage, so if it's okay with you.
Well, I don't care. Okay. I just don't feel really.
Have you ever heard of Joanna Lumley? No. Okay. I don't know if this has ever happened to you, but
is she an actress?
Can I ask about the dress? Is it important that your front bits show here? Because you have no underpants on.
I just wanted to point that out.
I know a lot of people wouldn't mention something.
Well, if I was going on the show, then that would be a problem.
No,
since
I know,
I'm
but
not,
in the dressing
okay.
room, things like that. Do you want a pair of underpants?
No.
Okay. I mean, to another girl, it's not an important issue. It's obviously an American habit that they come to foreign lands and they think we don't have a kind of air conditioning system, so they just
make their own.
It's nice that you're sharing that lower half with me, and I don't even know you. So all I want to know is you started off as a kind of, do they know what, was it a scream queen in B-movies? Is that an insult?
Not to me.
No, but you started off like in Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the lines that you said in some of those early films, if maybe you remember some of those lines. Come on, one.
Pay me.
We are paying her. How much are we paying her?
Oh, then.
Yeah.
I think
she knows how much we're paying her. What's the line from one of those shows? Okay, just make the face.
Make the face
of horror.
There, I did it.
But wasn't your head more like this? I always say
no, because then it shows you have to have dental work.
All right, orthodontist. You see, you know these tricks.
I know.
You know those
I'm
tricks.
I'm a professional.
Have you had your teeth done? That's all.
Yes, I have,
they're
actually.
They're perfect teeth. Because, look, I had my teeth done. No. Is that like, that's American work and this is English work? They leave the
but
plaque
But you're from
on.
America.
No, I know, but I was here in my formative years. And they like to leave a kind of layer of yellow on so that I'm one of them. See, you're too scary because it's too perfect.
Yeah, well.
Neil, are you shooting her head? Are you shooting her head? All right, because he does that sometimes.
I'm sure.
He does. don't do her breasts, Neil, because...
Oh, please, they've already done them.
Yeah. No, God, we're so tired of those old breasts.
Yeah.
Those breasts have starred in their own movies, haven't they?
They have an insurance policy.
Because I see that there's some shots in some films where we just see your breast and we're guessing it. Isn't that in Trading Places? It's just breasts.
There are a couple.
Yeah. And they won an award.
They might have, yeah.
They won an award. Would you get... Are you shooting her face? No, I
but
don't
he
know.
Has that concentrating face again. See?
Well, he's excited. That's him excited. He's looking at a woman with no underpants.
He's not aroused.
Believe me,
he's not aroused.
Excuse me, could this camera, is this man aroused? I'd like everybody at home to just bring Neil's lower half and write in whether you think Neil's better. Star. Yep. We got two on the show tonight.
Who's the other one?
Joanna Lumley.
Yeah, but she's not, she'll be out there. I'm not going out there.
Yeah. Really never heard of Joanna, huh?
No. But you know I'm from America.
Yeah. I used to go out with Harry Shearer.
Oh, really?
And
I know Harry. Harry got married.
I know
to a wonderful singer, Judith Owen.
Oh, wonderful, yeah. I'm not upset. I'm really happy for him.
But he didn't like you.
He told you?
Well, a little bit.
Seriously, because this
about.
Would kill me.
No,
are you
here,
being serious?
Just come here for a second.
What? Dallas? Mm-hmm. I wasn't in Dallas. So that wasn't even me. I can't believe it. I was really
Is your name Ruby?
Yes.
Trust me, it was Dallas.
Anyway, I was with Harry and your husband, Chris Guest, now husband, Chris Guest, when he was sitting in the Caprice, and he said, I was in Spinal Tap, and a girl called my agency, Jamie Lee Curtis, and said, I want him, and that's supposedly how you picked your husband, like a lobster at a restaurant. Did you just see him, and you knew this was the hubby for you?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because I love
I saw his picture in a magazine.
Yeah.
And called his agent.
That's fantastic.
Just said, I'll take your number.
And he never called you, or he did call you?
He never called
me. Oh, no. Did you wait by the phone?
No. I had a life.
Yeah. I mean, did you sort of do it joking, but you knew this was the guy you wanted?
No, I did it seriously. I thought he was beautiful.
You never did it before?
You mean call somebody?
Yeah.
No.
Because it's such chutzpah. I mean, I would be scared.
I know.
Scared.
I called my...
I'd be scared.
I know, but he never called me. I ran into him at a restaurant 2 months later.
And you said I'd called
you? No, he looked at me from 30 feet away and went like this. And I went... And then he called the next day.
Wow.
Wow. And we got married 4.5 months later.
But it's such a good kind of update on the thing, is to see a guy's...
10 years.
A guy's picture.
How'd you know?
About him. Because mm-hmm. Harry Shearer dropped me, and he was the last one left. Cut that out.
She's being honest. Yeah. We're grounded now, because no. the interview's getting really good now.
No, but I would have... I was seriously going out with this other person. And
Harry Shearer.
Will you aim...
You went to the Democratic Convention in Dallas.
I didn't, really, but I knew he did. And Harry Shearer was in Spinal Tap.
He was doing,
reporting
for NPR.
Yeah. And I wasn't there, I swear.
You were there! It was you!
It wasn't me. What did he tell you? Some insane groupie jumped on his head? Is that what he said
about me? No, he went there with you. He flew with you.
He didn't fly with
you. She's lying.
You know...
She was trying to protect her marriage. I'm telling you.
Okay, I had sex with him. I'm not lying about that. I'm out in the open. You didn't have sex with him, I know. But he was... If I could have gotten Chris Guest, I would have gone for him, too.
Have you ever met him?
Yes, I had lunch with him. I'm telling you, he's sweet. He's
in Dallas? Because he wasn't in Dallas.
I slept with your husband. Yes, it's all come out, okay? You've made me say it. Take my wedding ring.
I don't want your wedding ring. I want that one.
All right, take my real wedding ring. I slept with the husband you have now.
I don't think you did, actually, because he would have mentioned it.
Well.
We've told each other.
The front was that I was with Harry in Dallas, and I wasn't. I was with your husband.
Hey, you know what? No. I've got your ring and glasses. Take my husband.
Okay.
A good hearty squirt of deodorant. Because you never know when you're going to be invited to meet the Queen. That's what I say. Okay. Oh, for a second, I didn't know who she was. Oh, Ruby, thank you. Look, Ruby, will you just keep them warm? Because I want to go to the loo and freshen up.
Okay. Got one backstage and one on stage. Never ends. Okay, what I wanted to talk to you tonight was about... Sorry.
Where's the lavatory, Ruby?
Sorry, before I go on, can I just say another word about Joanna Lumley? You know, I'm never upset when somebody does better than me. I'm not, I'm really not. It doesn't bother me. I'm not upset, really. And if you can help someone whose career was not dissimilar to those squished animals you see on the roadside, well, then it just makes me a better person. And I'm happy for them. I'm really happy for them. I'm not kidding you. I am very happy. But, you know, you turn on your television, and there isn't anything in your home that this woman is not selling. I mean, I can't even think of sticking my head in the oven and turning on the gas. She sells it. My own children quote her lines, not mine, hers, and I wrote them. But, you know, I mean, you can't let you get you down. Otherwise, you'll go crazy. It could just make you insane. I'm not going to go on about it. It's okay. That's okay. It doesn't matter. I started them all off, you know. French, Saunders, Lucille Ball, Jack Benny, Elvis Presley, Flipper, all of them. Did anybody phone to thank me?
No.
Okay. Now we're going to show you a little footage of Joanna Lumley's humble beginnings. Just to remind you. Here's a few shots from the old days. Roll the film. Joanna's looking.
Are you on stage? I'm feeling fine.
Joanna Lumley is not a well person. She is actually very, very ill. She is having treatment at this very moment.
I'm going to kill you! What a joy it was to see you, Ruby. I always love it when you drop in that spontaneous way you have.
I'll take care of her now.
Well, then give her plenty of fluids and change her twice a day.
Okay, get out of here. Joanna, do your cockney.
Good, it's a blooming shame, Shell. I'll have to tell Arthur about it down at the Vic. Could you explain the rules again, please?
What's the point of doing that? You're f***ing useless.